I'm dumbfounded. I can't believe what I've just read. This shit is too crazy. Like, this put my brain on cooldown for like 3 days. It's been so long and I'm still processing what I've read. It was truly something else and an experience I recommend to anyone. It was truly the best manga arc I've ever read. So let's get into the explanation of why I think that. My name is Abisu and welcome to my blind review of Berserk. What is there, it's just a sand. What it's dry in your crown. I'm spanning my grass. Today, we're taking a look at the last section of the Golden Age arc. The chapters covered are 57 through to 109, which is also the same material that the third Golden Age movie covers. From now on, I will be covering one arc per video, even if the video is like 2 hours long or something. It's honestly so much more exhausting having to make 3 separate videos than just the one long one. So the last act of the arc starts by Guts beating up some big ass Pussio in a small tournament a year from the last time we've seen him. It was nice to see a light-hearted action scene after the last section and the tense ending that it had. And through this small tournament, we come to know that the Hawks are still together, even after the ambush, which I forgot to mention in the last video. They basically just got jumped because Griffith clapped Charlotte's cheeks, and after this attack, they were left very weak, and most of them didn't even make it. After the attack, Casca became the captain since Griffith has been getting tortured for a year now. Honestly, I can't even imagine how bad of a state he's in right now. After the tournament, we move on from Guts and spend some time with the Hawks and get a true grasp of how weak and pathetic they really are right now. They've been under constant harassment from the mercenaries hired by the king, so they've been on the run like all the time lately, and this time it's no different. They get attacked and the one leading the charge is actually the big old Pussio from before. Luckily for the Hawks, Guts comes to their rescue, and bro, Jesus Christ, what an easy fight it was for Guts. What a big pussy. Even your mum pussy ain't this big. Okay, that's the worst one so far. That is definitely the worst one so far. I find it so funny how Guts literally spent a year just training in a cave. And this is what sparked a thought in my head. How bad must have the caves smelt from all the sweat? Okay, so also this is the Middle Ages, so like none of the characters have like a clean ass most of the time. So like, they're walking around all musty and shit. And like, this man Griffith really be out here saying shit like, I want your guts. With like, a booty just full of shit. No, but like, literally look at any scene and just know that their clothes have shit stains on them. Just know that, just think of it. Okay, anyways, Casca tries to fight Guts, and honestly, this dude has the mental strength of a Nokia 3310. He just handled the situation so well, and I don't know how. I don't think I'd be capable of doing what he has done. Honestly, just hats off to Guts. You know, whilst you're there, dicks out for Guts too. Just, what a fucking legend. And bro, him and Casca finally fall in love properly. I didn't think this would ever happen. You know, if you watched my last video, you know that I predicted this wrong. So, let's hope the rest of the predictions are wrong too. fuck. Bro, this scene between Guts and Casca made me cum shit and cry at the same time. Okay, I was lying about the shitting, but what a scene overall. They do end up having sex, which I can't really show you, but you know. I'm gonna tell you that it was portrayed in such a almost non-sexual way. It was really more about the love between the two characters than the, you know, the act of just having sex. It was so pure and emotional. It's so sad that it was ruined by a PTSD moment from Guts. Like, it's a shame that it was ruined, but it really helped to push the relationship forward and only make Casca and Guts become closer together in the end. Guts even asks Casca to travel with him, which he couldn't do earlier on. Just, what a legend. He's come so far. Just, what a scene, bro. What a scene. I love this. Also, what a plan to rescue Griffith. I'm really looking forward to this. I'm really curious about how terrible of a state he really is in. Like, just think about it. He must be, like, barely holding on to life, whilst he's probably completely insane at this point. And
This is actually exactly what is shown to us at this point in the manga. We get a glimpse of how Griffith has basically started losing his sanity. And chronologically, we actually get the first glimpse at the God Hand, which obviously can't be any good with the state Griffith is in. Honestly, bro, if they do something to him before Guts saves him, I'm not going to be happy. Okay, so here's the plan to save Griffith. They have an inside man in the castle. You know, it happens to be Charlotte because, you know, she's a simp. She leads them to Griffith, they get him, and they escape all good and dandy. And, well, you know, we all know plans don't work out all that well most of the time. So how does it go? They enter the castle premises through a spooky-ass cemetery, not without Charlotte being a spoiled brat and making a fuckload of noise before they enter, and they eventually make their way to the prison that Griffith is hidden inside. And holy shit, that is one spooky fucking prison. Like, the amount of atmosphere is actually kind of crazy. Like, from the looks alone, it feels like the scummiest people alive are sent there. Like, absolutely vile creatures. Okay, well, whilst we're here, I just have to speak on how, like, another moment in the manga was completely ruined by my Zoomer humor. Like, this is an emotional point, and yet again, I'm just being an idiot. Like, I am sorry if this kind of sounds insensitive, but the moment where the guy's like, I'm just a little deformed man. Bro, I don't know why, but that was just so funny to me. Like, before he was trailing them, and, you know, he had the funny silhouette where, you know, he looks a little dorky, and then he comes out being like, yeah, I'm just a little deformed man. What about it? Like, I don't know, I found it really funny. But anyways, let's get serious. Griffith has been completely crippled. He's not going to be capable of doing anything ever again. He's been completely mutilated. The tendons connecting to his feet and arms were cut, so he can't walk or use his hands. His tongue was cut out. His body has been experimented on and even skinned in places. His muscles are atrophied, so he's literally just there. He cannot live. He can just exist now. Like, not only was this a horrifying discovery for me, but he also sent Guts into a rage. We have never seen him this angry before, and the dude just goes on a killing spree. Obviously, the plan didn't go as they thought, and they got ambushed, but I don't think that's really gonna matter to a man who almost lost his best friend. He's just gonna slice through everyone so easily. Also, the king sent Hulk and Slenderman after Guts? No, I mean literally, the fucking Avengers come to get Guts. As the group is escaping with Griffith, they get jumped by the Avengers. And you know, they do have like a really cool fight scene. But then, you know, they get out, and yet again, it's a horse chase scene. And honestly, this is the best horse chase scene yet. And this scene introduces us to a complete vile piece of shit. In fact, it's the first apostle throughout the series, you know, if we're speaking chronologically. And this guy is so fucking disgusting. Like, I want Guts to end his shit so fucking bad, you don't understand. This is such an intense scene too. Like, the Hawks are being chased by the strongest thing they've ever come across at their weakest point ever. And they have to use every little trick they can to get away. And in the end, it's still not enough. This monster can literally kill a horse with a single punch whilst not being transformed. Bro, he literally tosses giant people around like it's fucking nothing. And Guts has to fight this. And what a fight it is. Like, Guts literally gets tossed about like a little pinball. Completely hopeless. But we all know Guts, don't we? The motherfucker is just built different. You think that will stop him? You think anything can crush him mentally? No! This guy defies all odds and wins the fight. He wins against the strongest thing we've come across. It might have had a dumb design, but I'm so glad Guts beat the fuck out of that. I did say beat the fuck out of it, because he does not kill him. That achievement falls onto Zod, who in Zod fashion comes out of absolutely nowhere, takes the ugly fucker out, and then disappears. Incredible job, Zod. You know, and after this fight, they were all happy and shit, until, you know, Griffith sees Guts and Casca being happy, and I honestly don't know what he possibly could have said to Casca, but now she wants to stay with him and protect him, since he's literally incapable of any human task now. And I don't know, this pissed me off so much. When Guts' life finally gets good, Griffith just has to make it worse. I find it interesting how this is exactly the opposite of the first act in the Golden Age arc, where Griffith very much was the reason why Guts' life got better, but now he's slowly becoming the bane of his existence. And trust me, it gets much worse as Griffith somehow escapes from the Hawks and then crashes this wagon, and in the end, he still somehow survives. I mean, the man literally broke his spaghetti noodle arms, and he ends up finding the bailer. Like, Oh my fucking god, I just know this is going to be so fucking painful. You find a fucking bailer, he's crippled. Oh, this is just such a bad combo. And like, you literally don't understand how much I shit myself when I saw that. This is the start of the end. The thing that was coming for centuries, the eclipse. I don't just speak about what happens during the eclipse. Rather, I don't think I could. My words could never convey the emotions I felt during this section of the story. After being done with this, I literally told my friend, and I quote, "There is no way a human wrote this. I don't believe it." The way the Golden Age arc concludes is one of the many reasons that why I think this arc is the best manga arc I've ever read. Actually, bro, scratch that. Best thing I've ever read, full stop. I doubt you're watching this if you've never read it, but if you are, then please go and read this. Or maybe not. This has kind of ruined manga for me right now. Nothing will ever be as good as Berserk. Not in my lifetime, at least. I won't speak on everything that happens, but let me just go over a few events. First of all, Griffith indeed did sacrifice every single hawk, just as I predicted. Second of all, once he becomes a demon, Ahid was something absolutely despicable to Casca. The thing that he saved her from before, he does to her now. And because of this, Casca loses all of her memories and she's just a shell of what she used to be. Also, the way Guts loses his arm is just heartbreaking. We see him the angriest he has ever been, and it's completely understandable. Griffith is single-handedly the biggest piece of shit ever, so lost to his dream to the point of sacrificing everyone who ever loved him. I know this video isn't as long as I planned it to be, but there is just not much I can speak on at all. This broke me. I'm still recovering weeks after reading it. This arc is just incredible, and the dynamic between Guts and Griffith is unparalleled. The way Griffith grants Guts happiness and a place to belong, and once Guts has surpassed him, he finds a way to ruin it all and take away everything which he gave to Guts. It's just not something I've seen ever before. I have never seen a world more alive and believable than this one. Each character behaves like a real human being. They act human. Even the heinous things Griffith has done can be understood. And that's what I hate so much. What he did makes sense for Griffith. Nothing comes across as uncharacteristic. And what might bug me the most is that nothing is ever explicit in Berserk. You have to draw your own conclusions on what happens. You make the decisions whether what a character has done was right or wrong. You suffer alongside the characters, wondering what just happened and why it turned out that way. I just don't understand how this arc can be so perfect. I really don't. Might be a bit of a tinfoil hat moment, but I genuinely can't believe this was written by a human. Miura, how did you do this? I'll leave you guys with a quote by a friend of mine. Just feels like a world. Not a story that was made, but one that is being told. Watch Bakuman, subscribe, and peace.